Hey there, YouTube, Escato5000 here, what's up? Here is another retro deck profile. It's called Bazoo Card Trooper Return, so here we go. We got free Bazoo the Soul Leader and free Card Trooper. So basically what these cards do, Card Trooper, you mill the top three cards of your deck to the graveyard, and this gains 500 for each one. So, and when this is destroyed, you can draw one card. So basically, this provides ammunition for this card, Bazoo the Soul Leader. Bazoo the Soul Leader's effect is, when it's on the field, you can remove three monster cards from your graveyard from play, and it gains 300 for each one removed. And this becomes a 2500 attack point monster until the end of your opponent's turn, obviously. So, it's a really good card. Really good, because a lot of combos. As you can see, these are the monsters. High power monsters. This is, like, self-explanatory, because basically, when these are in the graveyard, this becomes food for Bazoo the Soul Leader, and this becomes fuel for the cards Dimension Fusion and Return from a Different Dimension, which we'll get into in a little bit later. The Dark Necrofears, three of them. Basically, this is here because just for like insurance. Basically, its effect is when it dies, you can equip it to one of your opponent's monsters and take control of it if this was destroyed by battle or by a card effect. And you also have the free Snipe Hunters, which is also good in two theories. The first theory is you discard monsters like this to add food for the Bazoo the Soul Leader and to destroy one card on your opponent's field. And this can also be fuel for the Dark Necrofear summon. So banish two of these and one Necrofear in the graveyard by discarding it with Snipe Hunter. If you have a second one in hand, summon this guy. A lot of combos you can pull off, obviously. So that's free Snipe Hunter. Self-explanatory, you discard one card from your hand, you roll a six-sided dice, and if you roll a 2, 3, 4, or 5, you can destroy that one card on the field you selected. Then you got two Gravekeeper Spy, you got two Cyber Phoenix, which basically makes your Cyber Dragon and this monster immune to spell and trap cards, like it can't be targeted. And then when this is destroyed, you can draw one card. Then you got two Exile Force. Just attribute this monster and destroy one monster in your opponent's field. Then you got one Morphin Jar to refresh your hand. If you don't have any good cards to get out of a jam, you just set this, and when they attack this and it's flipped up, you discard your hand, you start all over again. Draw five new cards from the top of your deck. And then the final piece, Magical Merchant. Now, I'm gonna say this. The Magical Merchant, Card Trooper, and Bazoo the Soul Leader, they all play a role of their own, because basically what these guys do is basically provide like the combination. This helps you try to get Return from the Different Dimension or Dimension Fusion to your hand, and this also mills your monsters from the top of your deck to the graveyard, which provides the ammunition for Bazoo the Soul Leader, like I said before. And it's really good, and also can get some fiend monsters into the graveyard for Dark Necrofear to come out to the field, obviously. So there's a lot of many combos you can pull off with this build, because this build was one of the best builds back in the 2007 format, obviously. Now for the spells, you got free Smashing Ground, you got Future Fusion for the free Cyber Dragons. You can go into, like, for example, hold on one sec, I'm just gonna grab the fusions. As you can tell, I run the free Cyber Dragon Fusions, Cyber End Dragon, Chimera Tech, Over Dragon, and Cyber Twin Dragon. Alright, so, and that's why Future Fusion's there. Snatch Seal, Heavy Storm, Premature Burial, and Dimension Fusion, and the Return from the Different Dimension. Now, this is where Magical Merchant comes into play. When you flip this up, when this is flipped up, or if you flip it up, you, like, flip cards over from the top of your deck until you get a spell or trap card, for example, like one of these guys, and then any monsters you flipped up due to this effect, they go to the graveyard. So basically, when you get these cards, you basically could set up a one-turn win on your next turn. Like, if this hits, like, Demok, a Jinzo, and a Cyber Dragon, and then you summon Bazoo the Soul Leader, remove those three, and you set this from your previous turn, you flip this up, it's game over, basically. It's basically, Jinzo comes to the field, they can't Tarantula or Mirror Force your monsters. It's so obvious. Dimension Fusion is another great card. Like, I have a video of me using this build against one of my friends who was using this build right here, which I'll make in another video a little bit later. I actually used a second Magic Merchant, and it got me that. So that's how I won, obviously. And this also helped me win the third game of the match, obviously. So Dimension Fusion and Return for the Dimension. This is what makes Bazoo Return totally awesome. Now, another card that can help is Two Skolair. Basically, what this card does, basically, you remove a monster from your graveyard, and you select one monster on your opponent's field whose level is equal to the monster you remove and destroy it. So it's really a good card. And this card was really underrated back then, because this can only be good in stuff like Macrocosmos decks or Bazoo Return decks. This card was pretty surprising in some of these kind of types of builds, because basically this card's only use is if your opponent has a monster on the field and you have a monster in your graveyard that has the same level as that monster. Like, it's that good. And that also adds fuel to the Return from the Dimension and Dimension Fusion. And you also got 2 Sakurazu Armor, 1 Mirror Force, 1 Torrential Tribute, and last but not least, 1 Call of the Haunted. So that's the Bazoo Return build. Hope you all enjoy. More videos coming soon. Comment and subscribe. Later.